culmination tonight in the security guard struggle that may have cost a young man his life. We first showed you the stunning cell phone video from Northland Mall last night. 24 hours later, we have learned there will be a wrongful death lawsuit. 7 Action News reporter Julie Bonovich talked to the family's attorney tonight, and she joins us live from Southfield right at Northland Mall. And Julie, what'd you learn tonight?
Well, Carolyn, the attorney says that McKenzie's family is devastated and that at first, police did not tell his mother the truth about what happened to him.
If 25-year-old McKenzie Cochran's struggle with Northland Mall police had never been caught by cell phone, his mother may never have known what really happened to him, says attorney Gerald Thurswell.
It wasn't until the next day when the video appeared on TV that she realized exactly what had happened.
Thurswell says police initially told McKenzie's mother something much different.
They told her a story that he had fallen and hit his head.
There had been no mention of 3 officers holding her son face down on the ground after he had been pepper sprayed. No mention of one of those officers digging his knee into her son's back. And no mention that her son cried for help because he couldn't breathe.
They can't understand. He was a sweet kid. He was a funny kid. He was just a nice boy.
When Southfield police arrived at the mall, the Ferndale man wasn't breathing, they say, but he had a pulse. Later, McKenzie was pronounced dead.
You have the weight of the officer's knee, and then you have the inability to breathe because of the pepper spray.
In an ironic and sad twist, we discovered that McKenzie's older brother is a police officer. He trains people on how to properly use pepper spray.
He was absolutely outraged. He said to me, he said, didn't they get any training? What are they using pepper spray as if it's nothing?
Thurswell says he will be filing a wrongful death lawsuit on behalf of McKenzie's family.
They actually killed him. They killed him.
And still no word tonight, no comment from Northfield Mall Police. We're live from Southfield. Julie Bonovich, Carolyn, back to you.
Julie, did the family's attorney tell you why they took him down and why they felt that so many officers were needed to restrain him?
He just mentioned that somebody thought that McKenzie may have said something. It's still not clear exactly what went down right before that.
But he was just saying something there in the mall that made the officers, you know, react that way. All right, Julie, thank you so much for the live report.